You are now listening to the Salty Virgins Podcast.
So, we are the biggest hypocrites that we know, personally.
I mean, we knew that.
We all knew.
Who's hypocrites?
Us, Patrick. Us.
I don't know what you mean.
Especially Patrick.
Definitely Patrick.
Well, also, you know, it's Patrick's Day. Especially Patrick.
Oh,
tell us why we're hypocrites, Patrick. It's your fault.
You did it.
I'll let him shoulder this blame. Pat, do you have any news you want to share with our listeners?
Yep, no, nothing at all.
any news Kara wants to share with our listeners?
Yeah, oh yeah, big time. I got engaged.
Congratulations, Patrick.
Yay, hooray!
Hooray!
Yeah, big time.
How'd you do it? Tell us a story.
Okay, so...
Double down on hypocrisy.
I recruited Kevin to take pictures of me getting engaged at a vineyard. Mm-hmm. So we did the wine tasting. We shared a bottle of wine, and then it was snowy, so I went up into a hill, and then I went on one knee and asked Kara to marry me, and she said yes. All the while, Kevin is freaking out because he lost his phone. Luckily, Kayla was taking a video, but
now,
this fucking guy.
I would like to say, Patrick had a negative plan on this engagement. I kept telling him, I was like, give me a plan, let me know so I can know what we're going to do. Some sort of signal, some sort of cue, do you want to set it up? And he kept going, I don't know what I'm doing. You know I have no plan. I don't know what I'm doing. When we're getting out of the car at the vineyard, my phone fell out of my jacket pocket, and then we went through the wine tasting, and the whole time, I was having such a good time with my pals, I never checked for my phone. We walked outside, and I'm like, all right, he's going to be doing it soon. I check for my phone, no phone. So I'm frantically searching for my phone. I'm asking Daniel, like, oh, like, let's do the Find My Friends. I'm like, I'm trying not to, like, make a scene or anything. And I look up, and Patrick's getting down on one knee, and Kayla's taking photos. And I was like, well, that's probably better. That's probably better for everyone involved.
Absolutely is. And now Patrick is engaged to his lovely fiance.
Big time. Already looking at wedding venues.
And then regretting deciding to get married?
No regret, just sadness.
His bank account still crying.
Not sadness because I'm getting married, sadness of the cost of getting married.
Kara doesn't listen to this podcast anymore. You don't have to defend it.
She does. Adamantly, she listens.
Angrily, she listens. Yeah.
She's
seething.
Yep.
She's listening right now.
Well, that's because she hears it in her house. She's just in the living room.
It ended up working out just so fucking well because it snowed. It doesn't really snow in Nashville, like very rarely. So like a couple times a year. The night before, when we got there, that day, there was like flurries. And then that night, it was just snowing.
Yeah, it shit snow like, in places it doesn't really snow.
Like inches of snow. We got back to the apartment that night and had a drunk snowball fight in the parking lot of our Airbnb.
Amazing.
Fantastic time. Also, I watched Kara fall harder than I've ever seen a human fall. We're talking about it. I get it. But she did not think there was a stair there. There was a stair there. And I've never seen a human crumple to the ground so fast.
She said her face touched the ground.
Oh, no.
Different Kara we're talking about.
Yeah, Kara too.
But since it had snowed the last night and it stayed cold, like it was around like mid-30s, everything was just kind of dusted with snow, but it wasn't too bad. So the pictures were just fucking awesome. Like, they're incredible photos.
Yeah. I put them straight on Instagram.
Yeah, we know.
I mean, to be fair, so did I.
Yeah.
We're all very proud and happy.
Thanks.
You did it, Pat.
Yes. Did good. Meanwhile, me and Jackson spent our lover's weekend just debaucherously drinking and sleeping. Big sleeping.
One of you also got a ring, right?
I didn't get a ring. I got a stud.
Neanderthal.
Sorry.
Yeah. I got my nose pierced this weekend. My mother still does not know, so she will probably hear this.
To the podcast.
Yeah, I was about to say, she's probably going to hear this and call and scream.
I want to hear your grandmother talk about it.
Make sure she's actually fine with it.
let us listen in muted through Discord.
It doesn't upset me that your grandma's fine with it because I'm happy she's supportive of you, but it upsets me that I don't get to hear her reaction to it.
Yeah, she, because I had talked to her about it a while ago. I was like, hey, I might get my nose pierced and I might get a tattoo. And she's like,
Ragman, sorry.
My grandmother does not have dementia, Patrick. She doesn't just start yelling that.
Oh, man.
But she was like, you know, as long as, like, it's not going to interfere with work or school or anything, I don't really care. And I was like, I'm not going to get a hand tattoo or a face tattoo, and I'm going to be able to put something in the nose piercing in 5 weeks. So.
All right. There you go.
So, it's not a big deal. I love it. I think it looks really cool. And the people around me, besides you guys, think it's really cool. So, I'm good.
Did you guys do anything else, like, in particular this weekend, or just drinking and sleeping?
Just drinking and sleeping.
We did. Mild watching of the XFL.
We watched the XFL. We also went to the
Solar Bears game.
Oh, those were incredible.
We got
the shit out of them.
Oh, yeah. I had some good ones. I was on fire heckling. Absolutely on fire.
Jordan was also the only black man there.
I was the only black person there within, like, I don't know, maybe seven miles, it seemed. Because outside of the Amway, there was some dude in the middle of the street dressed up like a carnival, like, animal keeper. But he had a whip, and he kept hitting against the ground. And I did not care for that at all.
One of the bars on Church Street was having, like, this Wild Wild West themed dinner party thing. So, bunch of old white people in their scooters with cowboy hats on. And then one, like, young person with a whip. Just cracking it in the middle of Church Street. Like, oof. It was a normal thing.
That's not great.
No, wasn't a fan. Gonna be honest with you.
Seems racially insensitive.
Nobody will get there.
Save.
Easy, buddy. Easy.
Nashville for us was eating chicken two meals a day and
fried chicken.
Fried chicken. We went out to Broadway every night, I believe.
Yeah,
we went to Broadway every night. Had a fantastic time every night. Also, when Daniel, Kayla, and I landed, it was 7:30 Nashville time. And we sat in the airport for 30 minutes trying to find a place that'll serve us alcohol. That a mimosa didn't cost $12. And we found a place, and we went there and promptly just started ordering continuous amounts of drinks. They were pouring us beers, Bloody Marys, screwdrivers, and a full bar was open. I thought these guys were going to hate us because it was kind of like a little uppity brunch place. But I think they were kind of digging it. I was asking the guy, he gave me the rundown of the beer list. He's like, you're going to like this one. He was like, I like the double IPA. I said, why? He's like, because it's 9%. And I was like, I like this guy.
I think they were digging it up into the point where you guys were screaming about waxing your buttholes.
No, I think that's when they started digging it the most.
That's about when me and Kara came in.
Also, I discovered on this trip that Patrick's really just a crotchety 50-year-old man that hates fun.
You just discovered that?
Kevin, I was driving a minivan. I had to.
That guy stinks. Party Pat stinks.
So we rented a car, and I rented a compact SUV. It was supposed to be like a Chevy.
Prius?
No, it was supposed to be a
compact SUV is not a Prius, my friend.
Like a Santa Fe or a Chevy Equinox. And then when I got to the airport,
trash cars,
they were like, we don't have any of those, so you can have a minivan. So I was driving, I was whipping a Dodge Durango through Nashville.
Also, Pat pulled the ultimate con on us by renting a car so he could go propose at the vineyard and then offsetting the charge onto all of us.
Pretty good.
We used the car a lot, and I had to deal with Daniel, so I feel like it was worth it.
We used the car specifically a couple times up until you proposed. Because you wanted to drive places because you rented the car.
We went to the liquor store like three different times.
That's true. We could have Ubered there.
You could have fucking GoPuffed or something, the liquor.
I think we purchased... The first day, we got a bottle of Crown Apple and a handle of Tito's and then a bunch of Coors and Bud Light Seltzers. And the Coors and Bud Light Seltzers were gone that night.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
And then...
Well, we went to a BYOB concert, so...
Yeah, not, so far concert.
Not the band.
Cool. But... I was like, what?
And then after Pat got engaged, I bought a bottle of Jack
like, what is it called? Jack Reserve or something?
Select single barrel?
Something like that.
Yeah.
So it's just like, we didn't need to buy more liquor, but it was like, it was worth it to buy it. It was super fucking good.
We finished that in one night.
You were celebrating.
That was gone instantly that night.
Yeah, that night. That was so good.
And I think we did leave behind a little bit of Tito's. So we didn't kill it all, but a lot of drinking, a lot of eating. Also, the best part of that trip, I mean, I guess besides Pat getting engaged, was...
yeah, I'd say that was probably the best part, but...
Coming back you would.
The bars the second night, and Patrick discovering we could Uber Eats 80 McNuggets and 4 large fries for $25. We had an unlimited supply of nuggets in front of us, drunk as shit, just sitting around the kitchen table.
I was just chugging nuggets. I probably had like 30 nuggets.
Yeah, a lot of chicken that trip.
I wouldn't definitely call
would
that
go
chicken,
back though. It was a good time. You say you didn't have a lot of chicken?
I said I wouldn't call it that chicken, but yes, I agree.
It's chicken-ish.
Chicken adjacent.
Yeah.
It's in the spirit of chicken.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'll still eat the shit out of it. Also, I got ridiculed for taking home 2 unused Hattie B's ranch containers.
Why would
No one was making fun of me when those McNuggets came. We didn't have ranch.
That's true. I'll
tell you that much.
I didn't see the vision.
Yeah. Still haven't gotten an apology, but I accept it.
Moving on.
Patrick seems very miffed about it.
Patrick was miffed the entire trip.
I was nervous and then sick.
Mm.
Are you saying you're sick that you now have a fiance and that you have regret?
All right, I'm logging off. What I'm I'll see you guys later. You're just
it's Valentine's Day tomorrow, Patrick.
Actually, it's Valentine's Day 2 days ago, Jordan. What are you? 3 days ago, Jordan.
3 days ago. There you go.
Listen, I never said I was good at math.
So,
yes, Kayla, you did.
Kayla oh. just.
Yes,
sent us
you did.
The tanks for the cruise looks awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
It's got the Salty Virgins Club logo.
It's really too bad that that guy with those beer straw hats is so fucking far out of the way. He does look so good with these.
Oh, man. That,
I
beer branded
listen,
straw
to any of our listeners, if you have, like, straw hats with, like, beer logos on them or know where to find them, please send us links.
I DM'd Coors Light to see where I could buy one.
Coors Light told you to go fuck yourself.
They did not respond. They did not respond for comment.
What a surprise.
I'm surprised, personally.
So yeah, that was Nashville. It was a really good time. Once again,
Orlando was fun.
Congratulations to Pat. All of our followers are invited to his wedding. His wedding has an unlimited budget.
That's true.
Open bar, unlimited budget. There's going to be lobster and also steak. So get ready.
I've also told him that a Sunday wedding is
and also cube limits. Steak. Don't worry.
There will be cube steak for the loyal listeners.
Mm.
Sunday wedding is off limits.
If I have cube steak at my wedding, I'm probably killing myself.
Kevin, I understand that little don't be broke flex there with a Sunday wedding.
No, having an open bar on a Sunday wedding is just a fucking insult.
To whom?
To people that have to work.
Oh.
Take the day off, coward.
You work from home!
Wait, and also, what time of the year are you trying to have this wedding pad?
We're looking at May.
Wow!
Wow! May 23rd.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
In the spirit of Patrick getting himself engaged, one of us is still dating, and I see a lot of the dating discourse on Wait, the bird.
Two of us are dating?
You know what I mean. Like, okay. You know what I mean. You are, like, 6 months in. Yeah. So, the dating discourse on Twitter sometimes finds its way across my desk, and buddy, are people fucking awful. Men,
wait,
women...
people on Twitter
awful?
Are not good people?
No.
We're on Twitter. You should have known this.
Nothing new here. Yeah, it's so bad hearing people talk about, like, I won't go to coffee with somebody because that's not worth my time. Okay. Like, have you ever engaged in, like, interaction with a human being? Having a cup of coffee is a lot of fun. if you like coffee or whatever, you know, snacks or whatever a coffee shop has, or complaining.
Like you're just a reasonable person.
Correct.
I'll also say, as far as coffee goes and like initial interactions or kind of early interactions,
it's so low stakes.
It's light, it's low stakes, it's very easy, you're in a casual environment, you have an out, like there's no time box. It really just feels like the fucking perfect storm.
There is definitely a time box.
Well, yeah, for you, shit box.
That time box is called my asshole.
That's a time bomb. Like, what was the other thing that I saw?
So I'm trying to think of Patrick getting up from a first date to just shit. It's an emergency.
Just blowing
Patrick had an emergency trip, a shit on our trip.
That did.
He kicked his fiance out of the bathroom while showering because he was about to shit his pants.
I was keeled over.
In his own words, he was rocking back and forth outside the bathroom door.
Hand on the wall.
Oh my god, Patrick was down bad.
At like 8 in the morning.
Yeah. Luckily she had just finished the shower.
She had not just finished the shower.
She was out. She just was not dried off at all.
Yeah, wet naked out into the hall.
I don't feel good about it, let's just say that.
You shouldn't. So another thing that sparked me to put this in the drive is people were fighting about going to Applebee's again. Like, people are really shitting on Applebee's, which, don't get me wrong, it's not the best restaurant.
Applebee's has a place.
It does. And I feel like if you're going on a first date with somebody and you don't want to spend $1,000, like Twitter seems to require,
dude,
going to... I have no idea.
Where are these people getting all this money?
I don't know.
I don't get out of bed for a date that's less than $100. Well, don't get out of fucking bed. Stay in bed forever.
Stay home. Please, bitch, stay home.
Take more hours at your minimum wage job.
Work harder. Like, what are we doing? Like, so, like, I like fancy food. I love it. I am the one who admittedly on this podcast is like, I'll spend $150 to go eat for myself. I'm not taking somebody on a $150 first date. Like, I'm not doing that. Because, like, what if I don't like you? Which I probably won't. Like, then I'm just out $150 and a bad experience? Not a chance. Like, why are people...
absolutely, like, fucking, like, emotionally invested before you spend that much money on someone else. And that's just... I mean, come on.
Or you gotta, like... nope, I can't say that. Never mind. All right. I'm just saying, like, you can't expect me to spend whatever, like, odd sum of money is worth it to you to go out with you, or you'll never speak to me again because that's what your quote-unquote worth is. But if you find worth in a dinner, you probably don't have that much worth.
Yeah, just don't speak to me again. That's an easy solution.
It's so easy. Please, never speak to me again.
When I was a single man, eons ago, I was a huge proponent of the movie and then bowling, and then if bowling went well, dinner. And I'd be out of there with a smooth $45. Easy peasy.
That's good. I support it.
And that's like a 6-hour date.
That's a lot of time, yeah.
That is a lot of time.
But to be fair, the movie, there's
silence.
Yeah. So really, the movie is essentially for yourself.
Patrick's like, I want to see a movie.
Yeah,
this person might sit next to me while I do it.
I need a reason to see Moana.
Yeah, I'm not going to sit by myself.
Me? Be a loser? I will not. But I like to do, like, I'll do dinner and drinks. That's not a problem. But I'm also not going to pick the most expensive restaurant in the area. I might pick something with a nice little happy hour where we can get, like, fun drinks or something. Something I wouldn't normally get so we can talk about it and try something different because that's what I like to do. But I'm not going to spend $200 for you to eat whatever the fuck you think that you're going to eat at some fancy-ass restaurant. For you to probably, and I mean somebody who assigns this value to a date, who probably is the worst person I've met this week or month. Like, I'm just not doing that.
That's fair. People on Twitter stink.
Absolutely. Out loud. They stink out loud.
Also derive worth from some of the weirdest fucking things.
The weirdest shit. Just the credit score. They derive worth from their credit score. Oh my god.
The weird fetishization of high credit scores versus like cash in hand is that's how you know like people are like dumb.
Just so dumb. Just so goddamn dumb. Like if you had 500
on god, if I have to hear someone say like I'll give me the credit, the line of credit. I'll make that money work for me. It's like, what do you mean? Can't invest if you're investing a loan. You're not making fun.
Just you're putting yourself in the hole.
I'm going to take $1 million loan and invest it and get a lower rate of return than the interest rate on the loan.
Or you could just have $50,000 and start whatever business you want to start.
Listen, none of these people are smart enough to start a business. Just take the fucking 50 grand.
But they're going to invest it in scamming. I don't know, bro. I don't know.
They're going to go buy Avon.
These people are, yeah, these people aren't even stupid enough to not get caught up in a MLM scheme.
The credit score thing, I'll never understand. Or the dinner with Jay-Z. Like, Jay-Z doesn't want to fucking talk to you.
Yeah, like, that's going to be the worst fucking dinner.
Like, Jay-Z, yeah, here's Jay-Z memoirs. Like, you know what I did? Sold Coke. You know what I did after? Sell out.
Jay-Z doesn't want to talk to his friends.
He doesn't want to talk to his family! What do you mean? You think Jay-Z and Beyonce are sitting down at the dinner table and having a conversation? You're out of your fucking mind! They don't have anything to say to each other at this point. She wrote an album about how he isn't shit, and it's like quadruple platinum. There's no way Jay-Z talks to Beyonce.
Yeah, not a chance.
Not a chance.
I don't know. We gotta stop talking about Twitter, but I want to, like, the fucking finance Twitter. People turning poor children, raising money for their other poor family and friends because their schools won't feed them into a glorification. People saying, I saw the tweet that was like...
Oh, what? $26?
Yeah. You know, what rent was in 2016 versus today, and then what minimum wage was like a 40% increase, no increase minimum wage. And the guy was like, what are you going to do? Complain about it or work harder? It's like, well...
you aptly pointed out there's a systemic problem, and then you were just like, nah, it's your fault, broke ass. And it's like, what are we doing right now? Like, you see the problem... And you're assigning the wrong blame. Like, you're just not getting to the right solution.
Listen, these people fucking love sucking corporations' dicks.
They're real bootlicky. And, like, I think there needs to be a real and honest conversation about, like, the weird...
About guillotines.
All right. So, one of the things I've always had to explain to my mother about Jackson is that, like... I'm a bit extreme and dramatic at times, but Jackson will always be more extreme than I am, no matter what it is.
I mean,
I'm not even going to like do people's taxes because I'm probably morally bankrupt to like avoid paying taxes.
That's fair.
I support it. I want to pay taxes.
Well, you don't have the option.
I'm going to pay taxes. That's just...
No way around it.
I already pay taxes throughout the year. They just make it so easy for me.
Exactly. Just fill out your form on TurboTax and send it in.
Don't use TurboTax.
I don't know. I'm not filing my taxes. Same page.
Don't.
Pat's probably doing it with his hands.
I use TurboTax this year, and I think it's the last year because I use TurboTax because I have. They're like, there's a edition that was I got it for like $40 because of investments and stuff. I did it on Credit Karma, and they came up with the same fucking number. And Credit Karma, it was so much easier. Yes. And I was like, well, what are you going to do? I'll eat the $40 this year.
And H&R Block are the like primary lobbyists of why taxes are complicated at all.
Yep.
Because if you make it complicated, you have to buy tax software.
Yep, that is true. That was a whole, like, big thing. I think ProPublica did a whole, like, three-month investigation into it, and it was like real
millions
bad.
Of dollars on lobbying to make taxes more complicated. It used to be you didn't even need to file a return. The IRS would figure out your return for you, and then you just get a check or be told pay us some money.
and technology has only gotten better. It would be so easy.
But times change, and so do taxes. And now Intuit's got Congress by the balls.
That was a top-tier reference, Jackson, I have to say. Top-tier.
Shouts to Trilly.
Shout-outs to Booger.
Well, to Booger.
Shout-out Booger and Tess.
Yes.
Do you still hate Booger, Pat?
Yes. I don't hate him.
That's a bad take.
I don't hate him as a person.
He's so entertaining.
He's so funny. He may be just wrong.
Being wrong is okay, I will say.
They kind of just need to give Booger like his own podcast or radio show.
Just sit Booger in front of a desk and just let him talk. This is a podcast
where I talk into a mic.
It would essentially be Creed Thoughts.
Yeah. www.
And you don't think that'd be amazing? He has just a great voice, too. Great voice and cadence.
Absolutely. Yeah,
Booger or Creed? I missed the...
Booger.
Oh, okay. I was like, I think Creed does, too.
Used to be. You never give cats a little salty treat.
How much you paying for worms? Who's your worm guy?
Finally, our... Black History Month segment was...
Melbourne continues to be the worst place on the planet. Who knew?
Melbourne fucking stinks.
You guys stinks are getting this out on loud. Monday, the 17th.
But we're Jackson's already blogged about it.
Recording on Thursday, the 13th. And if you haven't read it yet, go read the only blog I'll probably ever write.
I didn't even have to ask him to write it.
Oh, yeah, no, I thought, we can get on top of this. We can be the first of this content. This is going to blow up. This is going to be national news.
It's going to be a problem.
So, if you haven't heard...
it should be. It probably won't be. People are going to read this and go, what's the problem?
If this hasn't blown up, at least in the state by Monday, the story is that Dr. Chad Kirk of Melbourne High School had the great idea to have Black History Spirit Week.
Which, on its face, could have been good.
If it was Black History and not dress up in African costumes 3 out of the 5 days, and then blackface the 4th day.
Correct. But since it is that, it is not good.
But when I saw that, I was like, no, this is just fake. There's no way a real man, a man with a doctorate, a professional educator, wrote out that email and said, yes, this is a great idea. This is A+. People are going to love me for this.
Jackson, you are a white man. You understand the confidence of a white man.
Especially when the entire administration of Mel High is apparently just white people.
Yeah, you can get anything off.
Shout out to former O'Galley High School football coach, now Melbourne High administrator, Tim Powers.
Yikes!
Like, I don't know if Mr. Dr. Chad Kirk ran this by anybody, or if it mattered that he did because everyone else he's surrounded with is white and may have thought this is a good idea.
He was looking for a reason to wear his dashiki.
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 This man told students to wear, like, wear your favorite dashiki.
So, let's just go through the days.
It's like the guy from Get Out.
It's worse.
Okay, Monday, wear your African-themed dashiki shirt.
Wait. Before we get to this, please. Black History Month is not about Africa. Not even close. But Black History Month is not about Africa. It's about Black Americans doing things in America.
But Jordan, don't you understand? All the Black people came from Africa. They just walked onto the ships.
That's only facts.
Coerced or anything.
No, there was no conversation about any. Anyway,
we're sorry for the last 70 years of racism.
Oh my God, that was so bad.
Thank you,
okay,
Catholic Church.
Anyway,
all right. So Monday, wear your African-themed dashiki shirt.
If we have any listeners from Melbourne who knows or own their own dashiki shirt, can you please tell me? Because I have never seen someone wear that.
I'm black. I've never even come close to even buying a dashiki.
You know how many white people were going to Goodwill and thrift stores just hunting out?
I know.
That's the other thing. White people don't know where to get the dashiki.
I know.
They have no idea.
I know one person who owns one.
I think I'm shocked.
I probably know one.
I don't know any.
I feel better now.
I know black people, and I don't know any. Let's be honest.
To be fair, I'm pretty sure he played congos for a band.
Like I don't know if those two things...
African conga band or something. He did something that he required him to own it.
Oh,
okay. He did one of those black African things, yes.
Yeah.
The music, yes.
They like that, yes? Drums, beats, humming.
Yeah.
Tapping the rhythm, yes.
Tuesday. Wear an African-themed head wrap or turban. Now, there's a lot to unpack there.
To say the least.
Five of the eight words in that sentence, inherently problematic.
It's so bad.
Again, we're back to African and not, like, black American history.
Yes. Which is also not the point of...
Do African people ever call them turbans?
So... Like North Africa, no, like North Africa, Morocco, Egypt, stuff like that, they have that. That is a thing, yes.
Okay.
But also not the point of Black History Month.
Also, how wildly problematic do you think, like, the white kids would have been having them do this?
Do you know at least 30% of the school would have showed up in blackface?
Oh, yeah, and this is not even blackface day. We're getting
to the pinnacle, baby. We're building up to just the absolute most problematic day, Wednesday. Well, Thursday could be considered. You know what? These all stink. Let's not get into
this is not the problematic Olympics.
Wednesday.
And yet?
What he said was, dress up as an inspiring black leader from history. What he meant was, please wear blackface.
Please use this culture as a costume.
That we tell you not to do on Halloween as well. Same idea, just on a Tuesday of Black History Month.
Just when we're supposed to be celebrating these people.
Yes. It's great.
Thursday. Wear all black in honor of Black History Month. I mean, come on.
Are you supposed to be
come
Black
on,
Panther?
Man. The guy ran out of ideas.
He sure fucking did.
Listen. If black students showed up in all black, they get arrested.
Yeah. Like, I want a Black Panther tattoo on my leg, and there's no way you could get me to participate in that.
I don't know. I don't... Friday, back to the not understanding the whole difference between black and African. Wear the colors of your favorite African flag. Just pick your favorite.
Positive in all this, he didn't lump them all together as one African country.
He didn't say the African flag.
Yeah,
he did not.
True. That man is wearing South African covers.
Yes, the best country in Africa, of course.
Yes, of course.
The only country in Africa, actually.
Eating apartheid pots.
God, I'll see my fucking way damn it.
I'll see my
this room. Man said apartheid pods.
Was there any other content from the initial email?
I don't
think
so.
There's a follow-up email that I'm going to let... Or I haven't even read it yet.
Yeah, so that was basically... and signs off nothing after... Like, the last line is Friday. Wear the colors of your favorite African flag. Dr. Kirk, principal. And yeah. As you figure, bad... People were mad, and all I can assume is that the next day he had to walk all this back. And another email that says, "Dear Bulldog families, I made an error in judgment yesterday in supporting the Spear Week in honor of Black History Month. I realized this decision gave the impression that I took the history and challenges of our African American community lightly. This event has been canceled so that Melbourne High School can focus instead on our core mission of education. Teachers will be deliberate in honoring Black History Month through educational opportunities that expand student knowledge of the rich cultural heritage and critical issues in African American history. I wish to convey my personal apology to any individuals or groups who may have been offended by my short-sighted decision and pledge to lead our school community to providing more appropriate cultural education in the future. respectfully, Dr. Kirk, principal.
He's not getting fired, is he?
Sure fucking isn't.
Sure isn't. Not a chance.
He might get a promotion.
People are going to be mad that he canceled the event.
He's going to be Bombay's mayor, isn't he?
This man's going to be governor.
Also, he's, like, this is inherently terrible, right? But this is not a... This is
he's
not
the only one who thinks
this is not an uneducated man with this idea.
Well, but this also isn't like a one-time, a microcosm. Like, it's not that's not the right word.
That is the right word.
It's not a microcosm. Pat, just cut out all the idiotic words and just leave that one.
Keeping it up. I'm going to actually just loop it.
Just me stuttering for 5 solid minutes. But, I mean, we at a place that I used to work over the summer, they had a... No, they had a menu for Black History Month, and it was just like African dishes, and it's like that's not inherently bad, but it shows a complete lack of understanding about anything that has to do with Black History Month.
Yeah,
which enough people hate already for no fucking reason. I mean, why isn't there a White History Month?
Yeah. Well, because every month is White History Month, my friend. I don't know if you know this, but the whites seem to make history every day.
You know what's really bad about this? Guess the percentage of student population at Mel High that's black.
It's got to be like
6%.
Oh wow, Jordan's actually very close. It's 7%.
I mean, yeah. So it's like
everything's good.
Everything is great. Yes.
And to make matters worse, to make 2020 worse. Papa John's didn't even eat 30 pieces in 40
days. Yeah,
40
what pieces the hell? In 40
days. Sure fucking
everyone
didn't.
Just lying. Everything's bad. 2020, as we said, worse than 2019.
2020 is canceled. January seemed to be the longest fucking month of the entire, I don't know, last 25 years of my life. And then everything else after it is also bad.
I am getting married this year, though, so 2020 is going to be great.
Yeah, until we drink until we can't see and you can't walk down the aisle.
Single day is going to be good. Everything surrounding it, bad.
Just absolutely awful.
Oh, my God.
So, yes. We're all happy. But before we go, I need to end this podcast on a semi-positive note. We need to talk about the phenomenon that is Long Chile and Ohio, too.
Yes, we do need to
talk about it. At least we have some hope for the future.
Yes.
So, for anyone that hasn't seen it, there is a photo circulating. This was just like a local baseball beat writer that posted he tweeted about, I'm trying to find it now, there's a lot of scrolling. We talk a lot in this group chat, it's too much.
It's almost like we like each other.
He sent out a tweet with a discussion he had with his 16-year-old daughter. It said, "Got any homework? Nah. What you gonna do? Have a map I'm working on." And then he said, "I just found this on her desk." And it's a map of the United States that at first looks pretty normal.
This States.
The
American continents.
Yeah, the American continents. And it looks pretty normal at first. It's a little bit like off. There's for some reason Texas extends all the way to Canada. It's like okay.
Texas
and then
has
at the bottom
a 500
corner,
gallon hat.
Yes.
It says patch notes, which in and of itself is just so fucking funny.
Absolute comedic genius, I will say.
So it starts off. Mild. New Hampshire and Vermont have been combined into New Hampshire. North Dakota and South Dakota have been combined into West Dakota. Minnesota renamed East Dakota. Virginia renamed East Virginia. West Virginia renamed Virginia. Already we can tell this girl's an agent of chaos. Next, Florida lengthened, removing the coastline from several southern states, leading
all
to the Second
them.
Civil
Literally
War
all
and
them.
Florida's eventual secession.
Really
Florida's coastline extends until where the point
the
where Mexico touches.
No, the Arctic.
Because that part is Long Chile.
Oh.
Florida's coastline ends when it runs into Long Chile. We'll get to Long Chile.
And also Ohio, too.
So next we have Texas and Idaho also lengthened as decided by unanimous vote, and Texas and Idaho literally just go and touch the most northernmost part of Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Just cuts all the way through that bitch. The four
corners.
We
will not be tweeting this picture.
The four corners replaced with Ohio 2, and when you zoom in on the four corners, there's literally just a cutout of Ohio replacing where those four states touch.
Scale one to one with normal or the higher one.
it's a copy paste. And also, this is a hand drawn map, and it's incredible, by the way.
Yeah,
it's
so
accurate.
I could never.
Next, capital move to Ohio 2.
Getting Washington, D.C. out of here.
Chile becomes Long Chile, removing the entire West Coast and causing Chilean-American War. And Chile literally goes from the tip of South America all the way up through Mexico along the western border, all the way up through the U.S. and past Canada. It owns the entire western coastline of this entire two continents.
I can only assume Long Chile goes through the Arctic and wraps around to the other side of the world.
It goes back to touch Chile.
You think Long Chile has Alaska now?
I think Alaska's cut off from the United States. More so.
Yeah.
And will be eventually invaded by Long Chile.
The Long Chilean army will trek their way to Alaska for oil.
What a fire name for an army, by the way.
Yeah, that's
Long
pretty
Chilean
good.
Army?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
So the Chilean-American War is the catalyst of World War III, and then Wyoming is deemed unnecessary and removed. She just control-alt-deleted Wyoming.
Fair.
It's now just all that Wyoming land. I think Wyoming's now attached to Montana. I think those are the two states.
Yeah.
None of these states mean combined. None of those states mean anything.
Yeah. As a parent from this map. and then I think my favorite part of this whole thing is he has a couple tweets after that basically saying, I will note her disrespect for Wyoming is notable. She's long said... as a rhetorical non sequitur, is Wyoming even real? And this has been displayed on the light box in her room for several months. And it's just a light box with the word Wyoming on it.
in the center. Nothing else.
I've told her I've been to Wyoming, skied there, hung out there for a few days. It's a real place. She responded by saying, uh-huh. And then he texted her saying... my Twitter followers have several questions about Long Chile and other assorted items from your map. She said, well, let's hear them. I think they're broader, more existential questions like, why? And, huh? She said, they're not asking about the current map, though. Are they? My 16-year-old daughter just red-pilled all of us. So then he asked her about Ohio 2. And she said, Lamau.
Oh, wait, also, no. Ohio which is too. Actually way more funnier than we thought it is because it's not like state. It's just like unincorporated land.
Yeah.
It's just unincorporated land.
It's not a part of the U.S. anymore.
Nope.
Its sole purpose is to make people frustrated. And then he goes on to say, my Twitter's been totally unusable all day. It has over 14,000 likes, which is now up to like 400K. And she said, I'm glad I could cause an inconvenience.
In true 16-year-old fashion.
Is she 16?
She's 16.
Yep. Oh, okay.
We're going to get her on the podcast.
She might be our best friend.
She would also just destroy
us. We can't be your best
us.
Friend with a 16-year-old.
Kevin.
She would destroy all of us.
Do you know
us.
Who
she
we would... need to get on this podcast?
Dr. Chad Kirk?
We were at the bar in Nashville, and I was talking to some guy.
Yo!
And this man said he owns 70,000 cows in Wyoming.
Every year... He moves 70,000 cows. All does he move all of them?
Yeah. From Wyoming to Texas.
I can only assume for slaughter. And then re-ups his inventory of cows and repeats the process.
What
again.
An unfathomable amount of cows to have.
So, the person who would benefit from this map the most... Is that guy?
Oh yeah,
he would just be in Texas.
He'd have to. Go, he would have to move. He'd have to go around Ohio too, though.
That's.
I mean,
fine.
Wyoming doesn't exist anymore, so he might be.
I mean,
he might be out of here.
There's a border wall around Ohio too.
It's true.
No, Long Texas just puts a border wall around all their borders. You know,
yeah, no one's getting in or out of Long true. Texas.
That would make it so easy to get into Texas, though. You just go right a couple miles. Although Wyoming doesn't exist anymore, so I don't know.
Yeah, it's tough.
I've long said we should get Wyoming the fuck out of here. I'm glad somebody else sees the vision.
I saw that map and couldn't remember where Wyoming was.
Again, I think it's attached to what is Montana?
Yeah, it is. It's below it, I believe.
Yeah. Wyoming's the square. It's just a square.
What do you... God. Imagine 70,000 cows.
No, I won't do it.
What do you think the what do you guys think is the population of Wyoming?
70,000
cows. Yeah, no, it's like be less than the cows. 825,000.
I think the biggest
city about 25% less.
The really? Biggest city in Wyoming is like 70,000 people, right?
Yeah, it's wherever like the cows are congregated. Yes. Oh yeah. Oh wait. No. Yes. The most populous city is where the fucking cows are. Cheyenne is the state capital and most populous city with an estimated population of 63,624.
That's not a lot of people. Outnumber them. The Great Cow War is coming.
Oh yeah, definitely.
It's going to go about as well as Emu War.
So poorly.
Exactly.
I'm trying to picture 70,000 cows.
Kevin, I can't picture 70,000 grains of fucking rice. There's no way I could picture 70,000 like cows.
The swamp, instead of people, just cows in the stands.
The swamp's 110, though, isn't it?
It's yeah, like, but you think like, of how much bigger cows are than people.
Yeah, it's like high 90s, but cows, I would be surprised if 70,000 cows fit in there. Also, I can't do it. I can't think about that. I can't picture that.
I won't do it.
I was going to make a joke.
The entire population of the entire football stadium just filled with cow.
I was going to make a joke about the whole Florida fan base, but I'm just going to reel that one back in.
Moo! Just 70,000 times.
Breaking moos.
Okay.
We're done here.
That'd be a fun chat.
We're fucking done here. Thank you for listening to this wonderful episode of the Salty Virgins Club podcast. And remember that Black History Month is not about Africa.
It's about 70,000 cows.
Hold on, I have one more thing. Did you see the tweet? Not. Did you see the tweet I just sent you?
All of us?
Yeah.
The Harriet Tubman tweet?
Yes.
And
also, please don't celebrate Black History Month by getting Harriet Tubman on your debit card.
Throwing up the BX sign. Wakanda forever.
Wakanda forever.
Yeah, what the fuck is that?
All right, guys. We'll see you later. Spend my dollar. Park and holler. Need the mountain moonlight. Hold her up tight. Make a little loving. A little turtle doving on a Mason-Dixon night. It's my life. Oh, so right. My Dixieland tight. Make a little loving, a little turtle loving on a Mason-Dixon night. Fits my life, oh so right, my Dixieland delight. Going down a backwards Tennessee byway.